What's good, my babies? We are back again with another video, okay? Of course, we are using the prescription products. The information to get this will be in the caption below. Yes, I'm using my HD caps. I'm super excited to be back on YouTube, you guys. I'm actually in New Jersey and in the midst of me recording at my venue, I said, okay, let me just go ahead and knock them out and give them some YouTube content, okay? Today's video, you guys, is going to be very informative. This is a beginner-friendly video. It's going to be so much talking and so much information, but you're going to need it, okay? So I am using the prescription products, the prescription adhesive, light dose, which is the water base, which is my white adhesive. Today, we're going to be using both the ultra, which is the acrylic adhesive, along with the light dose, which is the white adhesive, to execute this melt for this install today, okay? As you can see, I'm doing my ball cap. I changed up my ball cap method. So if you want my new ball cap method, if you want me to update it from the one that I already have on my channel, just let me know in my comments and then I'll update it, okay? So you guys, what I like to do is I like to go ahead and put my wig on my client first before I go ahead and put that adhesive on. I just want to make sure that the wig is going to fit my client, and I want to make sure that, you know, the wig is not too small and we were not going to have any discrepancies in the midst of me executing this melt, okay? So once I do that, I'll come back and we are going to be using the light dose. This is the white adhesive, and we're going to do along the entire hairline, you guys, and you have to wait until it gets clear, okay? So pay attention to how I'm doing this, and then I'm going to tune back in. Okay, my baby, so I like to put dots. I don't like to run the glue all the way around the hairline. I like to put small dots, and I like to use my popsicle sticks to smooth the adhesive out on the entire hairline. I do this around my entire hairline. Now, I'm going to tell you the difference between my ultra hold and my light dose. My light dose adhesive is the white adhesive. That's the adhesive that I'm using, that you see me using on my model now. And this adhesive is white and it turns clear when it is dry, okay? With my ultra hold is an acrylic adhesive, okay? This adhesive is already clear. And how do you know that that adhesive is dry, okay? Good question. That adhesive is dry when it is no longer runny and it is no longer, when it's no longer runny and it's no longer sticky. Once it's tacking, but it's not too runny, then you know that the adhesive is dry. You'll see me doing it in the video as well. Okay, my babies, I'm gonna pause it. Now you see how that's dry? Now we're ready to put that next coat on, okay? Now we are using the acrylic adhesive. As you can see, this adhesive is coming out of the container clear. I'm going to put this along the entire hairline. This is my third coat, okay? I did two coats of my light dose, which is my white adhesive. And I'm going to do one coat of my Ultra Hold, which is my acrylic.
And I have two adhesives for you all to see if this glue is dry.
But you know, mix it up. Sometimes use just the Ultra, sometimes use just the light dose. Sometimes use more coats of the light dose than the Ultra. Sometimes use more of the Ultra doses than the light dose. Okay, so you know, get creative with it. And I want to see what I want to see how y'all get creative with the adhesive. It really works, you guys, and I'm telling you, just get creative. Pay attention to what I'm doing before I apply that lace. Now, just make sure that you're watching how I do this so you can see how to make sure that acrylic adhesive is dry before you lay that lace down. Now you'll see as I'm tapping the glue with my popsicle stick and with my finger just to make sure that the glue is not runny, and it's definitely tacking, but it's not tacking too bad where it's runny before I apply that lace down. Okay, so when I put my lace down, you guys, I like to put my lace down in the middle first, and then I like to go from the left to the right or from the right to the left, but I always like to start in the middle. And yes, I be needing my client to help me. Only time I don't have my client to help me is if I'm doing a different method. But like I'm showing y'all today, this is a beginner method. So we ain't gonna need to worry about that. We just gonna do it the beginner method. And with the beginner method, baby, you just need your you need your client, your model, whoever, to help you out, okay? Because you a beginner. She's making me feel like, ooh, ooh. When I get around you, I lose it, lose it. Cause I feel so comfortable with you. You make me comfortable with you. Okay, my baby, so this is a hair physician tip 101, okay? Make sure you get you a carbon comb, a rat tail carbon comb, and comb through that adhesive in that lace. Comb it. Make sure that adhesive is really gripping that lace. And it's super important that you allow that acrylic adhesive to dry, both adhesives. It's really, really important that you allow the adhesive to dry, period. So when you're doing this, when you're combing that lace into the adhesive, it's actually catching it, but it's not coming back runny. It's super important, okay, to comb that in and comb it in, because it grips it and it starts to melt that adhesive down. And I like to do the double melt method, okay? So I like to go one time and with the melt band, and then I like to come back after I take that melt band off, and I like to remove my lace and then put the melt band back on so I can melt it for a second time, okay? And yes, I am a stylist who sew my wigs down. I do like to ask my clients, but I like to sew my wigs down, and I'm going to show you all how to sew my wigs down, okay? Because it's super, super easy to me. So right now what you're seeing me do is I'm go ahead and I'm clipping the wig in, but I'm not clipping it too tight, because of course I'm going to change the camera, turn my my model around and show you all how I sew the back of that wig down, okay? And I'm actually doing plucking. I pluck before, during, and after my installs. Before is before I put it on my client's head. During is during the install, and after is, you know, once that install is done and it's styled up, I might go back and do like some extra plucking just to make it a little bit more natural, okay? So back to what I was saying about me doing the sewing of my wig. Pay attention to how I'm sewing this wig down. It's really, really simple, okay? I love it because it's very seamless, very simple, and it doesn't hurt, and it's not tight at all. And I've been doing this for years, and all of my clients like it, okay? All I'm doing is going up under that wig, tucking, pulling, that's all. I feel so comfortable with you. Okay, and this is my first time me applying my melt band, and I like to put my melt band on, and I like to go ahead and blow dry my client out, blow dry my model out, prepare my client for the removal of the lace, and also preparing my client to be styled. So pay attention to how I'm doing this. This is very simple. You're just going to put the lace band on, allow it to sit the entire time you're blowing out your client or preparing your client to be styled, okay? Okay, after I remove that lace band, it's time for me to cut off my excess lace, okay? This video is beginner friendly, keep in mind, okay? I do not recommend for beginners to use the eyebrow razors to remove the lace, okay? Yes, it is super easy, but I don't want you to cut yourself or your client. So as a beginner, I would recommend that you either purchase you some zigzag scissors from your local crafting store, or you get you some small scissors and cut in a zigzag or an in and out motion, just so you can prevent the line of demarcation. It's going to make your lace look super natural, and you're not going to cut yourself and you're not going to cut your client. Pay attention to how I'm doing it in this video. I'm cutting in a zigzag motion, and I do recommend that you do the same. My client is tinted again with the ruby kisses. The information for that will be located in the caption below of this video. And again, I'm using my the prescription products, okay? The prescription adhesive, both the Ultra Hold and the Light Dose, my HD wig caps, and I'm using my melting spray, and this is also a wig from my hair company, the prescription as well, okay? So all the information to that will also be in the caption below, and make sure you're following my Instagram, and make sure that you're subscribing to this channel, and you're enabling that bell so you can get all of my dope stuff when I drop it, okay?
On my knee, college begin, hop off a chick, and I get rich. Let's do no more, and I get a check. You still run on my pants and my jeans. She not a dress, even my piss. I eat her flesh, you know the rest. Kind of a hundred, couple Rolex. Shine at the sun, you truly blessed. Who's on the team? And they clip up like a hoobity jets. This is on me, got my Gucci shirt wet. Him in my bag, don't get used to the rest. I'm with this school, where they teach you for next. I heard this shoes with a drip, I invest. I'm the boss, man, I keep catching the best. All the cool fast when they in with it.
Okay, so after I'm done removing the excess lace, I like to make sure that my lace is secure again. So I'm going to be using my liquid skin. The prescription liquid skin is what it's called. It's a melting spritz, and I also like to use it as a holding spritz too when I'm getting done styling. I like to spread on my finger, and I like to put it on along the lace, and then I go back and I use my melt band again, because like I told you all in the beginning, I like to do the double melt method. So this is going to be my second and final time applying this lace band on, okay? Cool fast when they in with an S. The flame on the island, your couch kinda hot Okay, my baby, so when I just revealed this hairline to you all on YouTube, I also revealed this hairline to the people that is watching this demonstration. Like I told you all, I'm in New Jersey recording this content as I'm giving it to you on YouTube, okay? Y'all, the melt was amazing. Her skin is amazing, so flawless, so radiant, so chocolate and beautiful. Love the minute it... y'all know I don't know how to say Manila, and y'all know the vibes, but love the way that her skin is... radiant and how it's shining. The lace is executed really well. It's melted really good, tinted well, and I just love everything about this install. Again, this is a beginner's install for a natural hairline, okay? I'm going to be doing a side part, and I'm going to be styling her using my barrel curls, but I'm not going to be barrel curling. I'm going to be doing more so like a wand wave. I've been really, really getting into that look and like framing those type of curls. It's something that I'm really, really, really like digging right now. So pay attention to how I'm doing that. It's a really cute style. She just can't stop smiling, y'all, because she just loves her hair, and I loved it as well. And also to my beginner babies, when you're styling, it is super important that you're not styling on damp or wet hair, okay? Make sure that you're thoroughly blow drying out that hair. Make sure that hair is super, super dry before you start to use your hot comb and before you start to use your utensils to start styling, okay? It's super important that the hair is completely dry before you start styling, because if you're going in styling wet hair, it's not going to give you the look that you're trying to execute, okay? Okay, here's another hair physician 101 tip, okay? You control the hot comb. The hot comb does not control you, okay? You'll see me manipulating this hair with the hot comb. You can do it high up you want it. Volume if you want volume. Sleek if you want it to be sleek and flat. You control the hot comb, okay? And you just use the hot comb. Don't be scared of the hot comb, okay? If you're scared of the hot comb gonna be scared of you and you're gonna burn your client, period, okay? Pay attention to how I'm doing these curls and how I'm pulling them out, y'all. It's a very, very simple and cute and elegant everyday look. Okay, now that I am done with my curls and those are complete, I'm going to use my Lite holding spray, and then I'm going to go back and I'm going to use the prescription liquid skin as a finishing holding spray before I frame my client's curls to fit her face, okay? It's super important that you go back and you face frame your installment. It just makes it look very natural, and it just makes it look like it fits your client and just gives you that unique look, so your client just looks like that install fits her, okay? Hey, my babies, this is the final look. The demonstration is complete. My model looks amazing. Her skin is amazing. She got her lashes on and she just can't stop smiling. She feels beautiful. I hope you all learned something from this demonstration today, as well as the people that is watching this live from New Jersey, okay? Make sure that you are following my Instagram. The Instagram is IMHairPhysician. The YouTube is HairPhysicianTV. Make sure that you're subscribing, you're liking my content, you're giving me feedback, and you're engaging. I want to know what it is that I can do on YouTube to help you be a better stylist, okay? Y'all already know the vibes, and we done, period.